Please introduce yourself and what you do.
Hi, I'm Lewis Gray. I'm author of LewisGray.com, and I work for Google, running Google Developers Live.
And so, social media, what's your main objective personally for using social media?
Social media for me is a great way to not only share in things that I'm interested in, what I'm doing, but learn from my friends and other people who are thinking about the same kind of interests that I have, be that technology or baseball or really anything that catches my eye. It's a really good place to find things out quickly in real time.
And so in terms of use, when do you look at social media? Do you have times in the day when you do it? Do you do your email first? Talk us through how you use it.
I don't think there's any way you can calendar your life around social media or email, to be honest. Social media and email happen between things. They happen between meetings, they happen between tasks that you have to get done. And so you can really start your day. I know a lot of people start their day with their tablet, they get their Nexus 7 out, or their iPad, or whatever else they have, and they go through all their emails, and once they've done that, they catch up on their Twitter, they catch up on their Google+, and I'm no different. I take a look at all my notifications, where are they coming from, the things that need attention right away, and then social media kind of pops up. It shows up in the middle of the day when you're thinking about something else. It can be interruptive if you let it become interruptive. For me, I like to find time really at the end of the day when all of my tasks are completed to dive in, find those things that maybe I've missed, share stories, the really peaks of the day, good photos if I have those.
Do you do that instead of sort of watching TV? You're sort of...
Yeah, I'm one of those, you call it a two-screen experience. People call it a two-screen experience because often they're interacting with the television of what's going on. For me, probably 70% of my mind is on the tablet and 30% is on the screen.
Right.
And hopefully I'm not missing anything on the television, which is important. I'll only touch the remote to fast forward through the commercials and then get back to the screens. And so what I can do with that is obviously make sure I'm caught up on everything that's happening around me, whether I'm going through RSS feeds, whether I'm looking at tweets or on Google+ posts, or even just responding to emails. While I'm catching up on TV as well.
So do you have any particular favorite platforms? Do you have a mixture of all of them, or how, talk us through the platforms you use and for what purpose?
I think for each one, there's no one right solution for everybody. I think what you have to find is the content that you're looking for in the right place at the right time? Is it the people that you trust who really care about it? For me, I think Twitter is a good site for things like breaking news. Things happen in real time. It's a really short way to have quick updates. It's good for sports. A lot of sports celebrities are using that. For more deep thinking and solid engagement, I usually use Google+. It's where a lot of the people who I know hang out, where we get to talk about technology. Things that are exciting to me happen there. And then Facebook is one of those things where the people who haven't yet figured out all the rest of the tools are still hanging out. Facebook is where my wife's friends are. And so I'll go there and see what they're talking about, the pictures of their own kids. And that's kind of something I do right at the end of the day to make sure I didn't miss anything, but not a place where I want to spend a lot of time.
Yeah, and in terms of Google+, in terms of, you obviously use it in Google and out of Google. Talk to us a bit about that. Has it changed your life at all about how you organize either in working in Google or out, and how do the two work together?
Sure. I mean, I was a Google+ user for not too long, about 2 or 3 months before I joined the company. That was because they introduced it when I was in the middle of being interviewed. And so when I used that, I used it like any other tool that I've run through on the web, finding the people who are interesting, posting what were going on, making comments, taking actions, be they plus ones or likes, depending on the platform. Now that I'm part of Google, people interpret things a little bit differently. Even this conversation, they'll look at it and say, am I representing the company at this time? And so you have to think a little bit stronger, is what I'm doing something that I should be doing? Is it representing the company well, for example? But for me, I've tried not to let that get in the way. I am who I am. I have a long track record of posting and sharing and sharing updates on my family and sharing updates on what I think and my positions on tech. And I don't think they would want that to change. And so with Google+, it's a great platform for that. It's a great platform to share something and see it get reshared. What I really like about Google+ is that capability to take something small from anyone and bring it to a much larger audience and to track it. One cool thing I was close to was the launch of Ripples. And Ripples are a way for you to see a project get reshared and see who the influencers are.
Right.
Who else has shared this video? Who else has shared this link? Was there a conversation on that link that didn't happen on me? And I don't think there's any other platform where you can do that.
Yeah, and what about Hangouts? Has that changed the way you work? Has it made you know, interacting with people more human? I mean, has it had a big impact?
I think it hasn't just changed work, it's changed everything. I've been traveling the last few days. I was in France and now I'm in London in the UK. And yet every single day I've talked with my kids face to face. My kids are 4 years old and 2 years old. And so they don't exactly know where their daddy is, just that he's not home. But Hangouts can be a way where I can just click a button, my wife's phone rings, her computer bleeps at her, and lets her know, hey, dad's ready for a Hangout. And so I've talked with each of my kids and we've connected personally every single day. The cool thing about Hangouts is it really breaks down those barriers. It doesn't matter what the geography is. You can meet with people in your circles who you know extremely well, or you can just hang out with the public, and anybody who can join who's interested or hasn't really tried it yet can get to see you for the first time, and that's been exciting.
Yeah.
It is a good way, as you mentioned, with business to really connect instead of meetings, you know, instead of having to go across campus or instead of having to fly in or drive in, you can just talk to somebody and schedule it as if you're in the same room together.
And devices, what's your kind of device strategy? Are you mobile most of the time, you know, use your mobile phone or, mm-hmm. you know, talk a bit about that.
Look, when I'm at the desk, I use a laptop
pretty
much all the time. My main device is a Chromebook Pixel, a very strong device. I've been Chrome OS only for about a year now, and I've been dabbling with it for about two. When I'm not on the Chromebook Pixel, I'm on my Android phone. I'm on my Galaxy Nexus 2011 version. I'm waiting to get, you know, 2 years down the road and then maybe get another Nexus device when those come out. For me, you know, I kind of start the day with mobile. So I begin that, you know, you kind of go through your tablet, get ready for the day, come into work on the laptop, and then close the laptop and get back on the tablet. And I think a lot of people have that type of function. And then when you're moving around, you know, it's hard to lug the laptop around and hold it in front of you.
Yeah.
So obviously I'm on the Android all the time in between, you know, when I'm walking from one place to another, when I'm on my way to lunch, when I'm at lunch, whatever else I'm doing, the Android is going to be there, kind of to be that second screen so I don't miss anything.
Okay, and tips, finally. Somebody's, you know, not using social media or has been mm-hmm. dabbling at it, and you know, what tips would you have for people getting having it more as a routine themselves? What would you say?
Just find out what works. And I know that's a generic answer, but you want to understand what your personal goals are before diving into anything, or before I give you a prescription of how to use it. For you, you have to decide what's missing that you're not getting from social media. Do you feel left out? Are there conversations that you're just not part of? Do people find out about photos, birthdays, events that are happening that you don't? Are some people just more aware of specific topics that you'd like to know about? So you'd want to find out, what are they doing that you're not doing? And very often the answer is social media. They're following different people and different friends, different trends, different ideas. They're in different communities. And those things are happening all over. They're happening on Google+, they're happening on Twitter, they're happening on Facebook, they're happening on your phone, they're happening on your desktop. And so what you want to find out is, what is the right role for you there? Are you a sharer? Are you a listener? Are you an engager? What kind of role makes sense? I think often people get caught up in reactions to their own content that they share. You know, I posted and only a couple of people liked it, and that just wasn't for me. But the reality is, it's not a popularity contest until you make it one, and that's usually not the objective for most people. What they just want to be doing on social media is the same thing they want to be doing outside of the computer, and that's getting attention, that's having an engagement, and understanding that people care about what they think and care about them as human beings. And if that can be conveyed across the social media, then that's great.
Lewis, thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Bob.